difficulty of feeling the emotions that you go through.
We do, yeah. We at least do that.
Yeah, you know, and then we can help get the ball rolling on the healing, you know, the process. I mean, there's got to be a start to finish so that, you know, like I said, there's coping time, you know, there's going to be mechanisms and things to cope, but, you know, you will heal, you know, if you want to.
Sometimes spirits need healing too, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Sometimes, like, they go through, like, a lot of stuff, like, they're hurt and upset, trying to work out why it's this and that happened, why they died when they did. And, like, I might have mentioned it before, but I've had ones come in and just sit there and cry on my shoulder and all and everything. And one of them had laid his head on my shoulder and was crying a lot of times. It happened a lot of times. You know, just like, because he felt comfortable, this guy and I, and spent so much time together. After he died, you know, he come hanging around us. So, you know, so we go balls to the wall, basically, to help him and his people.
Yeah.
You know, like, there's nothing we wouldn't do. You know, nothing we didn't do, you know.
Did
everything we could, and we're still working with this people.
Yeah.
You know, this has been 6-7 months of this, but I don't mind. This would do it for anyone, you know.
Just reach out to us, you know, we'll reach back, you know.
The same way we reach out to when we hear someone died violently on the news and whatever, sometimes they come to us, sometimes we'll come to them, and we check on them. Very often I check on them, make sure that they're getting settled all right, or if they need help crossing over, or they need someone to talk to. Very often they do, you know. No one else seems to see them but us, you know, or at least around here. So we always bring them on in and talk to them and give them some help.
That's right.
Now, like you said, like our focus is on homicides and violent death and stuff like that. But because tons of people die every day, sickness, old age, stuff like that. But so all the people that die, we figure we need to go where people don't usually go. And it's the stuff like this, you know. You don't see a lot of the mediums dealing with this kind of thing full time.
Well, I think I wanted to touch on a question I had here. When we were talking about, you know, not trying to be intimidating type people. You know, we're not trying to come off as, you know, anything but soft-hearted, you know. But
yeah.
This question is... what do you do when someone has something against you? You know, like, how do you deal with people coming at us with, I guess, you know?
Are they asking? I wonder if they're asking. I think they're asking about them, too. About in general, too.
In general, I guess, you know what I'm saying?
If this would apply to anybody. How do you do what when someone has...
What do you do when someone has something against you?
Oh, they're asking us. What do we do? Well, we ignore.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's all we do. Just give them a smile and be like, oh, well, you know.
Yeah, kill them with kindness.
Kill them with kindness. That's a good way to put it.
That's what they're doing. They're trying to criticize to make them smile. You know, that's what Paul McCartney said.
Yeah, that's all we do, you know. Like, if somebody criticizes, like, you know, like, say we write if someone writes us an email trying to be critical, I'll write back and just be, like, real friendly and explain what we're thinking. And then point out, like, look, you know, you might want to reconsider some of the things you're doing and think of rethink some things.
Yeah, I mean, people can make us angry just like everybody else, you know, but
not,
I mean, it's
not
it's,
much anymore.
It just doesn't seem to bother us, like, you know what I'm saying?
It bounces off of us, says basically, because of that.
Well,
that.
I would just say in one of my situations recently, I've had some encounters with some people that didn't think highly of me, and, you know, it made me angry a little bit, but at the same time, it's just my anger was something I needed to. That's something I needed to forgive them. You know, like I had to. It's a learning process for everybody. Like I just pushed my anger away. You know, but it didn't last long anymore. You know, because I do deal with. I get angry not in a way you're thinking of violence and this and that. I think I get angry like, why would somebody not like me? I don't understand. You know. You know, I guess anybody could go through that. You know, that's
when you get past that. I'm kind of past that. It just. When I was younger, I used to get upset when people didn't like me. I'm wondering why.
I'm just being honest.
But I was more lonely back then. I felt more lonely in the younger ages because I knew I didn't belong in this world. I didn't fit in. You know, I was different from most those people. I am different now. So is Jeremy.
Oh, yeah.
We're a lot different. They're not normal people. Yeah, you know, we're far from the average everyday people in this world. So, not trying to be arrogant, but we know we are. It's a lot different. Most people don't think like we do or go through the stuff we go through.
Yeah,
and it's a lot different than most people's lives. So
yeah, and being able to read people so well, you
check
them
out.
Keep them. Being able to read people and stuff, you know, it's not really that easy because, you know, some people feel like, you know, like you were mentioning earlier, you know, some people feel overwhelmed. Like I feel too psychic for my own good with a comment that you're.
Yeah, we got to interview Tony, my friend Tony, who raps. And if you look at some of the other videos on my site here, he freestyles.
Oh, yeah.
You see Tony and Randy JR on there at Cecil.
I'll give Tony a shot. He's
good at it.
He's a star. I mean, he just comes out like.
He carries himself like a star already, and then psychically, he's headed there anyway. Some of our friends we know, like, we got to give a shout out to Tony. Yeah, to Tony and Cecil might make it. Ready Rock.
Happy
birthday, Cecil. And to Andrew, the white boy. Hey, you know, my friend White Boy, man, I've known him for years. And his brother, Red, he goes by Ready Rock. You've probably seen him over in Southside Plaza selling his CDs. He's going to make it. You know, Ready Rock's going to make it. You know, we've seen that cycle. He's going to be a famous rapper. He will make it, you know. And but Tony will too.
Yeah, Tony. Yeah. But didn't he say that or something? Or somebody said something along the lines of something about, you know, it could be some people can feel too psychic for their own good.
Tony
know?
Was saying that. Sometimes
Tony, yeah.
Tony's becoming so psychic now. He's getting information that he's not prepared to handle.
Well,
you know,
I can feel that. You know, you see what I'm saying?
We turned his mind on. Tony spent so much time learning from us and. Now Tony's a great psychic.
He's doing great, yeah.
And he's becoming very powerful. So that's what I've always wanted for him. And Tony used to say, he didn't used to believe some of the stuff we were talking about. Now he does because everything has come true.
Yeah.
We told him, and it gets and more. Everything came true and more.
What they say, the results are in the pudding.
Yeah, the proof is in the pudding.
The proof is in the pudding, yeah.
And that's what he's coming down to. He's turned it to a great intuitive,
yeah.
Just by virtue of learning from us, hanging around our vibes. And it just won't stop. It keeps on power becoming more and more powerful.
Yeah, he's doing a great job. You know?
So I'm trying to train him how to use it to help people more. He has been using it. So we got a couple more minutes, but... You're going to see a lot of people. You'll see Richmond blow up as a famous city eventually. It's coming. It's going to be like a more of a music city, kind of like Atlanta might be. And a lot of, like, it's going to be well known. A lot of rap music is going to be coming out of Richmond eventually. I see that coming psychically.
Yeah.
But we're going to close it here. We're about at the 20, almost at our 20-minute mark. So we're going to start the second video.
We'll be back.
In a second. All right. Peace.